Well, you also now you've got X number of books, whatever that adds up to now. 26 letters in the alphabet, we could figure it
Yes,
out.
yes.
But you have these feelings we alluded to in the show about film and film rights.
Oh.
Tell me
I
about this
will. Thank you
because
for asking.
you have worked in the
Yes.
film industry.
I published early in my career. I wrote seven novels, of which two were published. One was never published, the second was never published, the third was never published. The fourth novel was published. That was called Keziah Dane. The fifth novel was called The Lonely Madonna War, which is sort of the Hatfields McCoy. And that the film rights to that book sold, and I went to Hollywood and made my little pocket full of change and learned to do screenplay form. What I discovered after 5, 6, 7 years, I now call it doing 1 to 15 in Hollywood, I realized it just did not suit my temperament at all. I don't want help when I work. I like to work in isolation. And for the way, for my purposes, that serves me. So I was not happy in Hollywood, and I wrote A is for Alibi as my way to get out. I liken it to using a teaspoon to digging under a prison wall, but I did it. And so there were some years where I was doing screenplay form, television pilots, movies for TV, while I was writing A is for Alibi and B is for Burglar. It took me till G is for Gumshoe to earn enough money from the books to wave bye-bye to my friends in Hollywood. Now, when they say, well, don't you want to see Kinsey Millhone on the big screen or the little screen? It's like, no. They would ruin my work, and they would expect me to be happy about it. You know, I call it taking their fine gold pencils to my work. Not going to happen.
It reminds me of another writer who has such a vested interest in film but doesn't want to sell the rights. Garcia Marquez, has a similar relationship. So.